Welcome to another tutorial. In the last video, we discussed the object-oriented programming language and its basic elements. Today, we will use an object-oriented programming language, apply some of those basic elements, and create an Excel add-in. We will use Visual Basic .NET language and the Microsoft Visual Studio as our IDE. Microsoft has introduced a special project to automate MS Office applications through computer programming. It is called Visual Studio Tools for Office Applications, or VSTO. Today, we will use that to develop a basic add-in. From there, you can apply your own imagination and creativity to create add-ins as per your requirements. Let's start our today's tutorial. Open the VisualStudio.net and create a new project. In the Create New Project window, look for Excel, Visual Studio Tools for Office add-in and select it. In the project name, choose and enter the name of your project. Select its location. A project contains all the items required to create an application. A solution may contain many projects. You can choose a different name for your solution. You can also choose to keep your solution and project in the same folder. Finally, select the appropriate .NET framework. Computers with older hardware, operating system, or office application may require older .NET framework. Then, click on the Create button to create the solution. After this, you will see the actual Integrated Development Environment, or IDE. The main class file is already open. In our last video, we discussed the basic elements of object-oriented programming language. A class is one of them, and the most important one. It creates an object, which contains properties, functions, methods, and variables, among other stuff. On the right side, we have Toolbox, Properties, Solution Explorer, etc. Solution Explorer contains all the items in the solution. Here, you have solution at the top, and then the project, and inside the project, you have all the files necessary for your application, which you are developing, in hierarchical order. References are the libraries used in the project. Toolbar is used when we design GUI, and properties contains all the properties of currently open file. In the Solution Explorer, right-click on the project and add a new item. From the Add New Item window, select the ribbon Visual Designer and enter an appropriate name for it. Now, add the ribbon to your project. Now, you are going to design a GUI, for which you will need the toolbox. And toolbox now has all the tools you can use in your GUI. From the toolbox, let's add a checkbox to our ribbon. Go to the properties, and change its name to font bold, without any spaces. You can add CHK prefix to the name, like old ways. Change the label to font bold. Clicking anywhere outside the current property will apply the changes. Press Ctrl S to save the changes. And run the project. The add-in will be added to the Excel in the Add-ins tab, where you can view and use your add-in. You can add to other tabs as well, but we will use the default tab. Here is your add-in and the checkbox you added to your add-in ribbon. Close the Excel and go back to your project. Press the stop button to stop the project and make other changes. Change the title of group 1 to auto format using the label property. Add another checkbox and call it font color. Add another checkbox named cell color. Find a color dialog in Toolbox, and add it to your ribbon page. Double-click on the font color checkbox to access its code. This is a click event function, which will trigger if we click on the checkbox. We will add an if condition to determine if the checkbox is checked or not, and what to do if it checked. The best way to check if a code is working, before adding more stuff, is to add a message and run the code. Now, whenever the checkbox is checked, and it is clicked, this message will show up. And here it is. You can see that the checkbox is checked, and the message is displayed. It will not display when the checkbox is not checked. Now, if the checkbox is checked, we will use the color dialog box to select a color. First, we will display the color dialog box using the select case statement, in which we can use cases. Then we will add a case where the OK button is clicked on the color dialog box. In that case, the name of the color will be stored in the screen tip of the checkbox. Now, run the project and see if the code is working or not. Click on the checkbox, and the color box should appear. Click on the OK button, and the screen text of the checkbox should change to the selected color name. And the code is working great. Close the Excel, and get back to the programming. We will apply the same code to the other checkboxes too. Now, the other checkboxes will also behave the same way. Add a button to your ribbon. Go to the properties and rename it to apply. Change its caption to apply formatting. At this point, we need to create a function in this add-in file to apply formatting. We will create a public subroutine here, which will be accessible from outside this file. A subroutine is a function that does not return any value. The function will take three parameters as input. Font bold will require a Boolean input, meaning a true or false value. Font color will require a string input, which means a text. Cell color will also require a string input. Before adding a proper logic, we will confirm if this code works or not. And we will do this by using a message box. This message will just display the values of apply formatting function's input parameters. Let's call this function when the apply formatting button is clicked. Double-click this button, and the button click event code will be created. Anything written inside this will happen when the button is clicked. Let's call the apply formatting function from here. Remember, the function requires three inputs. We will add fake inputs here, just for testing purposes. Let's run the add-in and see if it works. And as you can see, the code is working. These are the exact input parameters we provided. We also need to add three more input parameters to tell the program if a formatting is to be applied or not. Apply font bold will tell the program to apply the font bold formatting or ignore it. All three parameters will require Boolean input. Apply font color will tell the program if the font color needs to change or not. And the apply cell color will tell the program if the cell color is intended to be changed or not. Now, go to the Apply Formatting button, click Event Code. The function is showing error, because now we need 6 input parameters, instead of 3. The logic behind last 3 parameters is very simple. Their value will be the same as their relevant checkbox's check state. If the checkbox's check state is true, the input value is true, and if it is false, the input value is false. We will also provide the actual values to the first 3 parameters, instead of fake values. The first parameter's Boolean value is the same as its checkbox's check state. Other two will get their value from the screen tip of their relevant checkboxes. Remember, we are storing colors in the screen tips of their relevant checkboxes. We have also added wrong code against font bold checkbox, which we can remove by deleting it. This checkbox does not need to select and store a color. Now, first we need to disable or delete the message box code. Now, we need to add the real code in the apply formatting function. First we will determine if to apply font bold formatting or not, using an if statement. The font bold setting will be applied if the apply font bold is true. Similarly, the font color and cell color will be applied if the apply font color and apply cell color are true. Actually, we need another checkbox to determine if font bold setting needs to be applied. Let's call it apply font bold checkbox. Change the code here from font bold checkbox to apply font bold checkbox. There is an error, we may have entered the wrong name. We use a button prefix here, let's change it to checkbox prefix. Prefix are not required, it's just a style of coding. Let's go back to this add-in file and code the remaining logic. Create a variable named R for an Excel range. Set this variable to currently selected range in Excel file. Now if the apply font bold is set to true, we will apply the font bold setting, which can either be true or false, to the selected range in MS Excel. Next, if the apply font color is set to true, the font color of the selected range will change to the color stored in font color checkbox, and we will pick it by its name. Finally, if the apply cell color is set to true, the cell color of the selected range will change to the color stored in the cell color checkbox. Color is stored by their name in string form. Our add-in is now complete, let's start it and see how it works. Let's create a new file from Excel templates to test our new add-in. Let's select a range to test our add-in. We will check the font bold checkbox and click on the apply formatting button. Nothing happened because apply font bold was not checked. Let's check that too, and see the result. Now it is working, as it should. Let's test the colors as well. Font color works. There is a glitch, let's try that again, with another color. Cell interior color works fine. Interior color is now yellow as we wanted. So, we conclude our tutorial here, with the hope that you will find it informative and interesting. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.